That's me.
Mr. Tyler Boone for coming out here and playing this evening. We got to do a few shows together last year. It was a pleasure to get to have him back out here tonight. Thank you so much for coming and playing. This is another trick that kid pulled on me last night. He somehow made this E string start to go below there. Oh God, technical shit doesn't matter to you guys. But I figured out how to fix it fast. A few years back, my wife took me up to this awesome casino and resort in French Lick, Indiana. Yeah, you've been there?
I like Larry Bird.
Me too. Okay, so you're at least aware of it. All right, I like this guy. Okay, good. So I played golf for a couple days, and then we were sitting at the blackjack tables gambling. And this old fellow was next to my father-in-law, and I was just the three of us at the table. And he hated us. Not for any reason in particular, just because none of us were winning any money, and he was losing a lot. And he smoked exactly 29 cigarettes. In the 30 minutes that we were sitting there before he spoke to us. And when he finally talked, and I'm not making this up or making fun, he talked exactly like this. And not like with a stoma or anything, just that's just how he talked. And he explained to me that he'd been in the casino for 72 hours. And he hadn't slept. And all he'd had was two turkey sandwiches. And I sort of looked at him like he was full of shit. And then this lady brought him another turkey sandwich to the table. And she said, it's the truth. So at that point, as we were getting our ass kicked, I draw from my back pocket, whenever I'm gambling and start to lose, I have a picture of my two sons hugging one another. And it's the cutest thing you've ever seen. And I set it on the table so that the dealer can see the eyes of my two sons. And I explain to the dealer, whomever he or she is, I say, this is Liam and this is George. And every time you're taking money from this side of the table, it's not just from me, it's from these two boys that need that money for their future. And then generally, the luck at the table turns around. Well, this old fella thought that was the funniest damn thing he'd ever seen. Put his arm around me and shook me real hard. We both laughed. About that time, my wife came over and asked for some money to go play the slot machines, and I gave her some. And he said something in broken raga-kaka, whatever language it was. And she looked at me and kind of whispered, "You found your spirit animal." And I said, "Yes, baby, I have." I gave her a kiss and she went on her way. He looked at me and he said, "Son, you want me to tell you how to maintain a happy relationship if you're gonna be a gambler?" And I couldn't say yes, sir, quick enough. "Yes, sir." And he said, "First thing, never tell them when you lose." It makes total sense. And then he explained to me, he said, "But most importantly, never, ever tell them when you win." I said, "I got it." He said, "Just buy them some shit and they'll never ask any questions." And the next day I showed up back in the hotel room with a brand new pair of shoes. And that fucking, he was right. She didn't say a damn thing about it. So this is, this song makes me think of him. Daddy was a gambling man. He doesn't drink. He doesn't smoke. He doesn't fool around when he plays. tally just goes to pro. And when he's away, she can't help but feel the chill. His daddy is a cameraman, but mama loves him still. She counts her blessings while he counts his cards. The only other girl in his whole wide world is the Queen of Hearts. She knows he can't quit, he just hasn't got the will. 'Cause daddy is a cameraman, mama loves him still. Mama said love comes with a price. It's a turn of the cards, it's a roll of the dice. He comes back home. She tries to hide the tears. She says, my dear, money's all gone. Let's be late sleeping. She goes to pawn a wedding band and bring him back the money. Pray for a decent hand. She prays that their luck will change, but knows it probably never will. 'Cause daddy is a gambling man.